What's up, everyone? Today we're going to be going over how to install the Facebook pixel on your Shopify dropshipping store. Now, I know you may be thinking that's something that's very easy, John. Why are we going over this? And the reason is because I'm going to show you how to install it without the new update of having to use this annoying Facebook sales channel. So if you've seen the new update, you have to go through and you have to register a page, an ad account, and a pixel all under one store on the Facebook sales channel. I really don't like this because I don't like specifying one pixel, one page, or one ad account to one specific store. I want to give Facebook as little information as I possibly can. So what we're going to do is we're going to set it up manually. What we're going to want to do is go into our Facebook Business Manager. Once you're inside your Business Manager, you just go hit on these dots for the business tools, and we're going to go to Events Manager. Once you're in Events Manager, basically what's going to end up happening is you'll have all of the pixels that you've already created lined up right here. They're all blurred out because I don't want to show the pixel IDs, but you'll have them all there. And then you can also go through and you can create new pixels. They are adding limitations now on how many pixels you can have per ad account, but that's not a huge issue. Just go ahead and create a pixel. Then what you're going to do after you create your pixel is you're going to want to go ahead and go into this overview section right here. So inside the overview, we're going to hit continual pixel setup. Over here, this is where you can do the partner integration with Shopify, but that's not what we're doing today. Instead, we're going to be going ahead with the install code manually. So when you come through here, you're going to notice that it tells you what to do. So the first thing that it says is you want to copy your base code, and then this little section will pop up where it says paste the pixel code into the bottom of the header section just above the head tag. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead, copy this code, and then we're going to go into the coding of our store on the back end, and we're going to implement this coding into the header of our store. We want to navigate over to online store, click on your themes, and then inside your themes, you're going to go ahead and find the theme that you currently have active. In that theme, what you would want to do is you want to click action and then go ahead and hit edit code. Whenever you're doing code edits or whenever you're doing modifications to the coding of any website, I always recommend instead of editing your active theme, the one that you're currently using, make a duplicate of that theme and do the code edits with that one so that you can make sure everything's working good before you publish it and make it live. So we're gonna go ahead and make sure that we have a duplicate theme that we're doing this edit in. Once you're in the theme, you're gonna notice all of this different coding in different templates, and it can be different for the different themes that you have, but this one's gonna be for the debut theme, and it will be very similar for the majority of themes, so it should look something like this. What we're then gonna do is go ahead and navigate over to Theme Liquid. In here, you're gonna see all of this different coding, but as it showed over here, we want to paste this just above the bottom head tag. So if we come back over here, you're going to notice we have a head tag right here, and then we also have a head tag down here, if I can find it. So we also have the head tag down here. So basically what it wants us to do is place this coding directly above this head tag right here. We'll go back over here and we'll go ahead and copy the code. Then back over on our store, what we're gonna do is we'll just hit enter and then we're gonna go ahead and paste that in there. So this coding is just the pixel base code. The next thing that we need to do, and this is why you need to watch through this entire video to make sure that you see all these little steps, because if you miss any little steps, the coding will not work correctly and you're not gonna get all of the events that you were expecting to come through on your Facebook backend. So now that we got the base code installed, back over here in the pixel setup, we'll just hit continue. Then in here, you have the option to turn on automatic advanced matching, which we do want. And we want to go ahead and check all of these because this will just give Facebook more information to create better audiences and better targeting off of. So this right here is the next section. And this is where things will get a little bit more detailed and a little bit more tricky. And it can go even more detailed and more tricky depending on how advanced you want to get with your coding. But we'll do some simple types of coding. And this is where you're going to go ahead and set up your events. So what we're going to do is we're going to have this option right here. It's an event setup tool. We're just going to go ahead and click that. So once you're on your website, what you're going to be able to do is create custom events that you're actually going to want to go ahead and track. So when you're going through, make sure that you're doing this all correctly because you want to make sure the events are being tracked. And of course, once you set it up, make sure you test these events, test them to make sure that everything's working before you actually implement it all onto your live store. So once we're here, you're gonna notice you'll have this little box that will come up, and you can do track URL or you can do track new button. So when you're wanting to get a little bit more advanced, you can actually go through and track different URLs, but we're gonna keep things relatively simple and just do track new button. You're gonna notice when this happens, it's gonna populate all these different things that it thinks you can go ahead and you can track. So right here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and click on add to cart. And then after we click on add to cart, we're gonna go ahead and label this with an event that happens whenever someone clicks add to cart. So of course, add to cart. In here, you can tell what the value is and what the currency is, but since it's just an add to cart and because there's no actual value attached to an add to cart, it's just an event, we're gonna go ahead and just leave that and hit confirm. After we do that, the next stage that we would wanna do is, of course, initiate checkout. On the initiate checkout page, the same thing we're gonna do, we're gonna hit the checkout button, and then we're gonna go ahead and add an event and do initiate checkout. This again, we're not gonna add a conversion value because there is no conversion value. It's just an event, so we are all good to go with that. Back here on the Pixel Event Manager, what we're gonna do is go into the Settings tab, and then inside the settings, if you scroll down, you're gonna notice you have the Advanced Matching, which we already turned on, but on the back end, you just wanna make sure that these are all still on. Then if we scroll down a little bit more, you're gonna see this thing that says Track Events Automatically Without Code. We do wanna turn this on because what this is gonna do is it's gonna let Facebook go through and automatically find different events on your website that occur. We want to let the pixel go through and crawl the website and collect all those different data points. So once you've got add to cart set up, page views are all good to go, initiate checkouts are all good to go, the only thing that's left is your actual purchase events. So when you come back into here and you're doing your event setup tool system, you can hit track a new button and then you can go into events and you can select purchase. When you select purchase, what you can do is you can actually select this option, which is choosing the value from initiate checkout. This is a great option if you're not doing custom conversion values or if you're not getting a little bit more specific, because what it's gonna do is it's gonna draw the total cost from your initiate checkout and it's gonna apply that as your conversion value. So this is a great way of setting it up, but you're gonna notice that once you get to this section, if you try to go to your checkout process and do this event setup tool, it's not gonna be possible. And the reason for that is because you can only edit your coding for the checkout if you have a professional Shopify plan. So when it comes to custom coding and setting this up, you would need a professional Shopify plan that will give you access to the coding on the back end of your Shopify store, where you can go ahead and you can start editing the checkout coding and implement your Facebook tags using this event setup tool with the purchase event. This is definitely something that you would want to use if you're taking things a little bit more seriously or if you're operating and trying to get a little bit more technical. But if you're trying to keep things simple and basic, use the automatic setup. And if you do decide to use these methods, make sure you duplicate your existing theme, do all the edits on the back end, and then implement it only when you know everything is working properly.
Come on, Spooky! Another one's gone!
But wait one second, there's a bonus coming in this video that I'm sure you weren't ready for, and that is how to actually set up your Facebook columns. I always see people posting photos or sending me messages and their columns are an absolute nightmare to look at. So I'm gonna bless you all with this because this is actually something that will help you so much. I'm gonna quickly go over your Facebook column setup and exactly why it's set up this way so you can properly manage all the data points. This is an absolute golden nugget, so make sure you watch this section of the video because this is such good free value. So when it comes to the Facebook column setup, this is my main column setup. As you can see, we have all of these different data points coming through here. And the reason why it's set up this way is because then we can go ahead and we can track the data and we can track the cycle of the customer through our sales funnel. So this is literally the cycle of the customer through our sales funnel. I'm gonna quickly go into here and I'm gonna show you exactly what these columns are. So what I'm gonna get you to do, if you're watching this and you're actually taking your business seriously, take a screenshot of this right here and go ahead and implement this on your Facebook account. And then I'm gonna quickly explain exactly how to track the data from these different data points. So this is the first section. We have all these different data points right here. As you can see, certain ones are unique. Make sure you're using the unique. Do it exactly like how I have it set up here. This is gonna benefit you in so many different ways. Then once you've got all that and hopefully you've taken a screenshot, We'll scroll down a little bit more. We were at the add to carts and the initiate checkouts, which were right there. This is the next section. Again, take another screenshot. We're gonna implement this and it's gonna boost your business. I promise you this. Now that you've got a screenshot of that, this is the final little section right here. We're gonna take a screenshot of that and go ahead and implement it. So now I'll go ahead and I'll quickly explain why my columns are set up this way and why it gives me the ability to properly track all of the data and see exactly how well my campaigns and my ad sets are actually performing. This is what we want to do. We have the cycle of the customers. So first we have the impressions. The budget is there just so that we know how much we're spending, but the impressions is going to show us exactly how many impressions, so how often our ads are being seen. Stage one of the funnel. The next stage is our CPM, because that's going to show us just how well our ad is actually performing. A lower CPM typically means that your ad is performing better in the Facebook algorithm, which means you're getting more impressions. Then after that, we have 95% video views. This is here because we want to see exactly how many customers are not only seeing, so impressions, but are actually watching through the video, so actually engaging with our ad or our content. Because someone that just sees it for 1 second and leaves, that's an impression, but that's not someone that actually engaged with our ad. So we have the 95% video views right there. Then after someone's shown interest in our ad, after seeing the ad, we want to see exactly where they went after that. Did they actually click through? This is why we have unique click-through rate all. And then we also have unique link click-through rate. So the reason why we have these two is because click-through rate can mean someone went ahead and clicked anywhere on your ad. That's a click, technically. But link click-through rate means someone actually clicked on the shop now, learn more, whatever you labeled your button as. So we want to see this because you're going to notice there actually is a discrepancy. There's a little bit of a difference in the amount of people that actually just clicked on the ad and the amount of people that actually clicked on the link. So this is valuable data because it shows you exactly what's going on with your ad and exactly how your customers are actually engaging with your ad. Then after that, we have the total number of unique link clicks. So this is the unique amount of people that actually clicked the link to take them to the product page. Next section of the funnel, baby. After that, we then go to unique landing page view, because when it comes to link click, that doesn't mean the person actually let your entire product page load. That's a very key thing. They may have just clicked the link to take them to the product page, and then when it was loading too long, they decided to click away and said, I don't even want to see that product anymore. So that's why we have here unique landing page view. And as you'll see, there is again a discrepancy in the numbers here. So we have more people clicking and less people actually landing on the page. So that's why this one's a much more accurate data point for seeing who actually clicked through, landed on our product page, made it to the next section of the funnel. So that's why that's so crucial. Going on to the next section of the funnel, we have add to carts, of course, because that's going from the page view to the add to carts. Then we have initiate checkout, and finally purchases, as you can see right here. So that's the entire cycle of the funnel and seeing exactly how the customer transitions step by step through the entire funnel. Then after that, we have cost per landing page view, because we want to see the cost of that section, add to cart, and purchase. We want to see the costs of all these different sections of the funnel so that we can analyze the data and see exactly how much it's costing to get a person to that section of the funnel. I hope this is all making sense. Then when we come in here, we want to see the total amount spent, because that will give us a good understanding of how much we've invested into that campaign. Purchase conversion, because that's going to show us how much we're getting back from that campaign. And then of course, purchase return on ad spend, because that's going to show us the data ratio of amount spent to purchase conversion value. So the entire sales funnel, how everyone goes through it, and the exact breakdown of the cost of each section of the funnel to give you an accurate understanding of what's going on with your Facebook ads. Now, if you're getting really analytical here, I'm sure you're wondering how to deal with the UK VAT and Brexit laws. So if you click this video right here, it's gonna actually show you exactly how you can go about set up your VAT, get ready for Brexit, and make sure that your store's all good to go with the UK value added taxes. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you did like it, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to The Creed for all future videos.